गुड। तो राजकुमार आवाज जा रही है?
जी सर।
अब तुम रिकवर हो गए ना बढ़िया से?
हाँ सर।
तो लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द टॉपिक्स व्हिच आई हैव ऑलरेडी सेंड यू द पीपीटी इन दिस रिगार्ड्स। तो लेट अस डिस्कस वंस अगेन अबाउट बैक्टोफेगेशन। Although you have studied this topic in brief in market milk or in other subject of dairy technology during BTech program, so here you have to study about in broad sense because it has huge application in the dairy industry. So you already know what is the bacteriophagation. You already know that there are several machines in dairy industry which is based on centrifugal force. So that is actually centrifugal force application have many in the dairy industry. Suppose you look for cream separator, definitely we can skimming the centrifuge and we can actually collect milk, whey, buttermilk and retained in the case of ultrafiltration. So similarly we can also use this machine. Even bacteriophagation you can use also for the other purposes also. So bacteriophagation is actually just advanced.
Sir, आवाज कम आ रहा
है। आवाज कम आ रहा है। मेरे तरफ से तो आवाज पूरा है। स्क्रीन बड़ा छोटा आ रहा है। अब जा रही है आवाज? आवाज आ रही है?
हाँ सर।
हाँ एक्चुअली हाँ वही मैं कह रहा था कि सेंट्रीफ्यूगल फोर्स हैव वेरियस एप्लीकेशन इन द डेयरी इंडस्ट्री। सपोज यू हैव टू स्कीमिंग द मिल्क, देन यू कैन गो फॉर क्रीम सेपरेटर, यू कैन गेट ए स्कीम मिल्क, और इवन यू कैन व्हेन यू सेपरेट द बटर देन यू कैन गेट द क्रीम और बटर और द बाय प्रोडक्ट इज बटर मिल्क। सिमिलरली इन केस ऑफ अल्ट्रा फिल्ट्रेशन यू कैन गेट द when we apply the ultrafiltration for the concentration of the milk particularly for the manufacture of whey protein concentrate or like that, so we can actually get the retentate from this process also. Suppose you have to standardize the milk, then the tri process machine of centrifugal separator or cream separator that is used for standardization, then standardization you can standardize the milk, you can standardize the milk for purpose of cheese making, you can standardize the milk for the purpose of butter making, any type of, suppose you are going to prepare whole milk powder, definitely you can standardize the milk. So these are actually also based on centrifugal force. So tri-process machine, which is generally available in almost all dairy industry, they are used this one machine for also not only for adjusting the standardization, but at the same time they are actually used for the other purposes also. Similarly, clarification, you already know that clarification is also one of the clarifier that is being used in the dairy industry to remove the extraneous materials or debris which is actually associated with the milk. So clarification is already the process which has been adopted in the industry since time immemorial. So clarification, which is also based on the cream separation, that is centrifugal force. Similarly, you are also getting the casein. You can also separate the casein from the whey. You have already studied the edible casein, industrial casein. This is also based on the centrifugal forces. Similarly, decanter centrifuge, you already know the chakka separators, which is used for the sirkhand making. Similarly, the most application, which is advanced application of centrifugal forces, bacteriophagation. That is the bacteriophagation is that we are by application of centrifugal force we can actually remove, as per theoretical, we can remove up to 99.9% of the bacteria of the from the milk. So we can actually improve the quality of the milk so that when we that use milk is used for the cheese making or for use for the butter or for the any other purpose like whole milk powder, skim milk powder, dairy whitener, then definitely we can overcome the effect which is actually caused by the spores or some bacteria which is actually not destroyed due to the after application of pasteurization. So bacteriofagation is, but in practical application we can actually remove bacteria up to 90%. But when we apply practically, when you work in the industry, then you can remove only 90% of the bacteria from the milk. So it is, you already know, this is the process which is especially designed centrifuge, which is called bacteriofagation, which is used mainly for the separation of microorganisms from the milk. But here I am giving emphasis on that there are other means by which we can actually remove the bacteria. Even in the pasteurization, we can kill 100% pasteurizers, but we cannot destroy the spores. We cannot remove the spores, but the bacteriofagation is the machine by which we can actually remove the spores even up to 95% of the milk. So this is the beauty of our bacteriofagation, that we can remove 95.5% of the milk from the whey. So the defects which is generally comes in the cheese milk from the cheese, that is late blowing defect, even in the condensed milk or dried milk, there may be some defect. They may arise due to the Clostridia or Bacillus group that is actually creating spores, which may actually hamper the quality of the respective product. Suppose you are preparing cheese, then you can definitely, when we not go for utilize bacteriofagation, then definitely we can suffer from the late blowing defect, which is one of the prominent defect in the cheese that is actually not desirable, not accepted from marketing point of view. So that is why when we apply bacteriofagation, that is why in the almost all cheese industry, bacteriofagation is actually being used. So this is actually based on the principle. This is something you can derive one formula. This is based just on the basis of we can actually remove the bacteria on the basis of centrifugal force due to the differences in specific gravity of the milk or skim milk or bacteria. We already know that the bacteria, especially heat resistance and spores, have higher specific gravity in comparison to the milk. So due to the higher centrifugal higher specific gravity, they are actually removed from the milk by using this formula. You can see here V is equal to sedimentation velocity of the bacterial particles, R is the radius of rotations, and omega is the angular vessel velocity, T is the diameter of the particle, PM is equal to density of microorganism, and PP you can say density of milk plasma, and another one is viscosity of the milk plasma. So this is the formula actually derived for the application of the bacteriofagation in the separation of the milk. So here you can see here that the specific gravity of milk is already, you know, in the range of 1.30 to 1.0030 to 1.304 up to 4. In case of buffalo milk, the specific gravity may be more than 1.036, and in case of buffalo milk. But in case of cow milk, the specific gravity is 1.028 to 1.032. Similarly, skim milk, that is already better, higher specific gravity in comparison to whole milk. So here the specific gravity once again increased, that is 1.035 to 1.037. And you can see here that the bacteria having a specific gravity larger than that the skim milk, or even from the milk. Or heat resistance spores, which is actually removed from, that is the main purpose of the, because we can actually eliminate the pathogens by the application of pasteurization. And we can also use thermization. Thermization is used at 63 degrees centigrade to 65 degrees centigrade for 15 seconds. But the thermization is not a replacement of pasteurization, because thermization is actually done in the dairy industry to remove to check the growth of psychotrops, because psychotrops are very much creating a problem or defect in the many product, even in the cheese that creates a problem. Similarly, in the case of dried milk product, we can get a problem. Even in the heat desiccating product, if this spore is present, then creates a problem. So heat resistant spores is actually not destroyed by thermization or pasteurization or heat esterilization. So bacteriofugation is used, or simply they not affect the quality with respect to the nutrition. When we apply pasteurization or esterilization, then somewhat nutrition is actually get destroyed. So this is the beauty of our bacteriofugation, that we can actually remove 95% of the spores from the milk, and practically we can remove the bacteria up to 90%. So when general efficiency of that bacteria is actually 80 to 90%. So bacteriophages, which are containing the milk containing bacteria and spores, and that is pushed forward and collected outside, bacteriophages. You already know that in case of when we remove the milk from the bacteriophages, that milk is once again collected and once again go for sterilization, then go for generally 130 to 140 degrees centigrade just to kill the spores, and that milk is once again bacteriophages, so that we can actually control the losses of milk in the dairy industry. So that is bacteriophages, that is centrifugal machine. We already know the use for bacteriophagation. And bacteriophage kya hai? That is bacterial concentrate and spores collected in the outside the periphery of the ball. Jo ball hota hai uske niche jis tarah se clean separator process machine mein jis tarah se baitha rehta hai niche, usi tarah se same bacterial concentrate or spores you can collect. And bacteriophagated milk, that is from which bacteria have been removed. And bacteriophages has always high dry matter than the feed. है ना, तो बैक्टोफेज का हमेशा जो तुम मिल्क सप्लाई करोगे, जो फीड करोगे, उससे ज्यादा होगा. यू ऑलरेडी नो दैट देयर आर टू टाइप ऑफ बैक्टोफेज, टू फेज बैक्टोफेज दैट हैज टू आउटलेट, है ना, टू आउटलेट एट द टॉप, वन फॉर कंटिन्यूअस डिस्चार्ज ऑफ बैक्टीरिया कंसेंट्रेट, दैट इज कॉल्ड बैक्टोफेज, थ्रू ए स्पेशल टॉप डिश, एंड वन फॉर बैक्टीरिया रिड्यूस फेज, दैट इज बैक्टोफेज. Another one is that the one phase bacteriophage has also one outlet at the top of the ball for bacteria reduce milk. And bacteriophage, that is containing the both, hai na, bacteriophage is actually collected in the sludge place, to bola ki niche periphery ke ball mein aayega, that is collected and discharged at three set intervals. So we can say here you can see the construction of two phase bacteriophages and one phase bacteriophage. So when we apply the bacteriophage, we can 3% of the feed, or in the case of bacteriophage here we can see that is you can just 0.15% of the feed. So you can see here that the all the parts, whatever in the case in the triprocess machine, or we can see the similar type of configuration. The only difference is that is actually rotate at a 10,000 g, hai na, gravitational force ka 10 guna hai. So we are actually use karte hain, aur usi ke anusar hamara uska jo strength hona chahiye, jo tolerancing capacity ka material hai, so isme hum use kar sakte hain. Here you can see the bacteriophage imply forces 10,000 g, matlab gravitational force ka 10 times. I installed Dawn steam in the series to clean separator, because heavier fraction, that is steam milk, contain majority of spores and bacteria. Bacteriophage reduces 98% of anaerobic spores. Hai na, anaerobic spores mein kon kon aayega batao, Rajkumar? राजकुमार
जी सर,
एनारोबिक स्पोर्ट्स में यू कैन नेम फ्यू स्पोर्ट्स व्हिच कम्स अंडर एनारोबिक स्पोर्ट्स.
एरोबिक जिसमें ऑक्सीजन की जरूरत हो, एनारोबिक जिसमें ऑक्सीजन.
अरे नहीं, तो एग्जांपल बताओ ना, एनारोबिक में एग्जांपल कुछ बताओ बैक्टीरिया स्पोर्ट्स का. which is actually observed in the dairy in the milk or milk product. अरे ये सब तो जानना चाहिए कितना बार
सीडोमोनास हो गया,
अरे
मैक्रोकोकस हो गया,
एनारोबिक बैक्टीरिया जैसे बैसिलस सीरियस एनारोबिक है, फिर क्लोस्ट्रीडिया, क्लोस्ट्रीडिया हो गया है ना, क्लोस्ट्रीडिया और फिर उसके बाद क्लोस्ट्रीडियम, दीज आर कम्स अंडर द एनारोबिक स्पोर्स. सो यू कैन ऑलरेडी नो दैट एनारोबिक स्पोर्स आर क्रिएटिंग सीवियर फूड पॉइजनिंग, पॉइजनिंग इलनेस इन द person who consuming that contaminated foods or product, है ना. तो जैसे तुम जानते हो क्लोस्ट्रीडियम, क्लोस्ट्रीडियम जब होता है तो क्लोस्ट्रीडियम बोटुलिज्म, जानते हो बोटुलिज्म जो कि बहुत ही सीवियर फूड पॉइजनिंग डिफेक्ट है, उस तरह से स्टेफाइलोकोकस ऑरियस पॉइजनिंग, ये भी एसओ स्पोर्स से ही आता है ना. तो ये स्टेफाइलोकोकस ऑरियस पॉइजनिंग भी होता है. अब 95% एरोबिक स्पोर्स, उसमें कौन सा स्पोर्स आएगा बताओ, 95% एरोबिक. तो ये वी कैन रिमूव 95% एरोबिक स्पोर्स और 93% लैक्टोबैसिलाई. लैक्टोबैसिलाई इज आल्सो रिमूव अप टू 93% व्हेन वी अप्लाई द सेंट्रीफ्यूगेशन. सो हियर वी कैन सी दिस इज द स्टडी व्हिच इज कंडक्टेड बाय द साइंटिस्ट दैट व्हाट इज द इफेक्ट ऑफ सेंट्रीफ्यूगेशन ऑन द टोटल बैक्टीरियल काउंट in the pasteurized milk and after pasteurization what is the actually reduction in count just after along with the bacteriophagation, that means pasteurized milk compared with the pasteurization after bacteriophagation. So we can here see that total bacterial count in pasteurized milk is 99.17. when we use bacteriophagation after pasteurization, we can see here that almost 99.83% of the total reduction in the count. So this, that is the difference. You can observe that what type of benefit they can provide. No doubt bacteriophagation adds to the cost of the manufacturer, but when we see the quality or the beauty of the pasteurization, that is bacteriophagation, that definitely we can definitely go for the utilization of bacteriophagation. So aerobic spore counts, you can see here that in pasteurized milk only 13% reduction in the count, but when we use bacteriophagation after pasteurization, then definitely we can remove up to that is 95% reduction in the counts. Similarly, in the case of anaerobic spore counts, we can not able to remove even a single percent of the spores, anaerobic spores in the pasteurized milk, whereas in when we apply bacteriophagation just after pasteurization, then we can remove up to 98% reduction. You can see here 98% reduction in the anaerobic spores. Similarly, leukocytes, here we can not getting any reduction in leukocytes, but here you can see even in the leukocytes is also remove up to, reduction up to 40% when we pasteurize, or we can use pasteurization along with the bacteriophagation. So this is the beauty of the bacteriophagation, that definitely no doubt we can pasteurize and eliminate almost all pathogens from 100% pathogens of the milk, but some spore forming bacteria or some aerobic spore forming bacteria, both are present in the pasteurized milk. So here this is the beauty. Or you can also see this, the process is all supplemented to pasteurization. We cannot say that pasteurization cannot be used. So pasteurization ke sath is supplementary, it is still necessary to destroy bacteria that not removed by bacteriophagation. Because bacteriophagation pura kill to karta nahi hai. That is why we are always at high school recommended the utilization of bacteriophagation always with the pasteurization. So this is the things we can see here. Then another one is that you can see how the industry follow the process. Similarly, quickly we can go for the raw milk, and that is actually preheated, and they are actually clarified, separated by the clarifier or dry process machine you can use, and you can sterilize. Then after that we can go for pasteurization, bacteriophagation, and bacteriophagation ke baad then we can go for pasteurization. That is the normal process, and then after that we can go for स्टोरेज और डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट मिल्क एट लोअर टेम्परेचर जनरली प्रेफरेबली एट 4 to 6 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड. सो हियर बैक्टोथर्म प्रोसेस, इन दिस प्रोसेस आफ्टर बैक्टोफ्यूगेशन द बैक्टोफ्यूगेट इज एक्चुअली फीड टू डायरेक्टली टू द बैक्टोफ्यूगेज स्टेराइजर. सो आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू दैट when we can separate the, we can get the milk with, along with the whatever we can get from the that containing the spores, bacteria or bacteria, that is some parts of milk. So that is actually once again go for the retreatment, and that is actually done by the sterilizer, which is actually infusion heater, that in which we can providing the temperature 130 to 140 degrees centigrade, because these are spores. They may be killed in this range of temperature for 3 to 4 seconds. And after cooling the bacteriophagate, it is once again remixed with the bacteriophagated milk before it is pasteurized. And this way, we can use once again whatever we have collected, the milk which containing the spores, bacteria, and that is once again retreated, or they can already sterilize in the sterilizer by applying the temperature 130 to 140 degrees centigrade for 3 to 4 minutes. And in this way, we can actually reduce the loss of the some milk. Another one is that the flavor or nutritional value of the milk remain unaffected. There is no loss at all in the case when we applied the bacteriophagation. Here you can see the bacteriophagate that is used in the dairy industry. This is the example of the bacteriophage with 2-stage bacteriophages. Here, this is the all science which is already mentioned here. Here you can see that milk, hai na? Milk is, you can see, one is pasteurization. Hai na? Here, this is the STST pasteurizer, and the milk is actually come from the reception dock that is actually collected in the tank, which is already chilled. And through the milk pump, the milk comes into the STST pasteurization. Then that milk is actually go for the cream separation. That is used. This is the cream separator, centrifugal cream separator, that you can go for sterilization, you can go for clarification, or you can go along with both. And then that is actually comes into the second. This is the two-phase bacteriophage. This is the two-phase bacteriophage. Here you can actually remove the almost 90% of the anaerobic, aerobic bacteria from the milk. Here we can, once again, the milk comes into this one, and from the milk pump, we can once again send, and here you can see that this milk is once again pasteurized, right? And then after pasteurization, then the milk is collected for other purposes. So here you can see bacteriophagation with continuous discharge and sterilization and remix of the bacteriophages. Here you can see that this is the heat treatment even for inactivation of the spores. Here we can collect, and that one is actually heat treatment we can give in, and that is comes through this one, and once again that is actually collected. This is the example of two-phase bacteriophages. Another one is that this is the one bacteriotherm with one-phase bacteriophage. So here we can see that once again milk is actually comes, this is the reception dock, this is the storage tank where the chilled milk is actually chilled, and that is actually through the milk pump that is comes into the pasteurizer, and that is actually then after pasteurization the milk go for the separation, and after separation that is once again go to the one phase bacteriophage. This is the bacteriophage, and from there we can once again discharge pump. This is the discharge pump, and once again go for heat treatment. Just to, the purpose is same, to inactivate the spores, kill the spores, and after that this is actually comes into the this process, and that is actually comes and collected for the other purposes. So go for cheese making, or you can go for whole milk preparation, or whatever according to your plan. Similarly, you can see the process of bacteriotherm. You can also see here the different kind of different things. Generally, you can see here that untreated milk, that is actually from the milk pump, it comes into the refrigeration section. That is the different parts of pasteurizer section. We already know that they comes into the refrigeration section. Then third one is bacteriophages. This is the bacteriophages, and fourth one is sludges. Lactofugus, sludge cyclone, this is this one, and fifth one is the positive displacement pump, positive pump, and from there they are actually comes into the sterilizer. This is the sterilizer where we can provide temperature 130 to 140 degree centigrade. So to inactivate the spores, here we can provide the steam through the knobs. This is the knobs where we can give we provide a steam to the sterilizer, and we can see here that is the first. We can here we can discharge pipe and from this centrifugal pump, and that is actually filtered through through this filter, and this is the flow controller, and that is actually remix. That is actually remixed, and through this one we are once again providing the holding. This is the holding, and they are actually holding. After holding, they are sent for cooling and treated milk. So here we can see just the process of Bactotherm in one sentence. Here we can use the untreated milk, then that is passed through the pump, then through the positive displacement pump we can send into degeneration section, and through that one that is goes with the bactrofugate, the cream separator, then that is bactrofugate. Here is the sludge cyclone, and from this this is the pump by which we can use positive displacement pump. We can flow upward, and here is the sterilizer. We can provide the steam through this means and maintaining the temperature 30 to 135 to 40 degree centigrade. Kill or inactivate the spores, and from this one after filtration collection we can push the milk into the once again the region, the heating section, and then the holding section, and finally the cooling section, and we can collect the milk for the different purposes. So these are the things which is actually very much important nowadays in the dairy industry. We can use this one. You can see this one bactrofugus in the Nalanda dairy. You also seen this one during your BTEC program. And what are the application of bactrofugation? The best application of this one in the cheese mill, because the anaerobic spore forming bacteria, they are causing a late growing defect, that is the prominent defect in the cheese. If this is present in the cheese, definitely the buyer will not purchase that avami, because late growing defect is highly undesirable in the case of cheese. That actually comes into the ripened variety of cheese, no doubt. They are comes into the after the ripening, after completion of ripening, or in between the ripening we can get it. So that is why it is always recommended to use pasteurized after pasteurized milk. You can bactrofugate the milk, then you can go for pasteurization, so that we can remove 100% bacteria, and also we can remove or separate more than 95% of spores, either anaerobic or aerobic. So this is to be very much important, when particularly for the cheese point of view. Even in the manufacture of any fermented product, definitely we can use. Definitely, if we opted bactrofugation, definitely the quality of the product will be superior. Superior, then you can get the bacterial count, everything of a high quality. So this is very much application, very very useful application for processing point of view, in the particularly for the milk. Similarly, whey, if intended for the manufacture of whey protein concentrate, particularly in the infant formula. So this is very much, because you know that infant formula, definitely we can always give emphasis on the safety aspect. So no any spores or anything should be remain present in the whey which is used for the infant formula. So that should be bactrofugated after recovery of fines and fat. For manufacture of milk powder, you already know that infant formula we are using the bactrofugation. Similarly, suppose we have to increase the shelf life of the pasteurized milk, definitely we can extend the storage life of milk up to 2 days when we pasteurize the milk along with the